So at Insightly, we actually use tasks to manage all of the tasks that we do at Insightly, if
right.
that makes sense.
Yeah, I use my task list every day to help me prioritize my product documentation, the copy that I write for the product itself.
Yeah, I use tasks for all the videos, like when it's time to edit a video or upload it to YouTube. So in this video, let's take a look at how to use tasks and maybe how you can incorporate them into your workflow. So here we are in Insightly. Where do we have to go to create some tasks?
So you don't have to go anywhere because from any page in Insightly, at the top, we have an Add New Task button. But you can also create tasks from the Tasks tab with a new task button here and from any of the main records. So when you're in a record, you can go to the Tasks tab, click Add Task, and create a task as well.
All right, we are fully task enabled. So let's set up one that we might use for ourselves just as an example.
Okay, so we'll go into a project and go to the Tasks tab and use that Add Task button that I was just demonstrating. And let's create a new task for John.
For me.
So as you go down the fields, you'll see that you can assign tasks to others or to yourself. In this case, John is logged in, so we're assigning task to me, meaning John. This will be a to-do. You can see various categories here, and you can even create your own. You put in a due date for a task. Let's do today. And the repeat option allows you to create a repeatable task. So every time you mark a task complete, it will create the next interval of the task for you. So John, we're gonna have you create a video every single week.
Every week without fail.
Without
new
fail.
New tutorial video.
We have start dates, reminders. If you're creating a task for yourself, you can set up a reminder. And what that will do is send you an email. And if you have our mobile app, a push notification on the date and time that you set up here.
Okay, so I'll always know that it's time to create a new video.
That's right.
When is it going to remind me?
So I'm going to remind you at 1 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Okay, good. 1 a.m. is usually when I figure out what I'm going to do the next day.
If this was a task that you were creating while you were working on it, you can mark your progress here, the status if you're waiting on someone else or deferred. We have priorities as well. I think this is a high priority, especially if we're going to be waking you up at 1 a.m.
Thanks, Tony.
Sure, you're welcome. We can see here that it's related to a project because we started creating this task within a project. If you're creating a task from one of the other options, you can actually search for and select a project to connect it in this way. You can create links to other objects as well.
All right, it's linked to you now, so everybody knows your involvement of it.
And we can create this as a public task or a private task, meaning only you would be able to see it if it was private or your administrators in Insightly. If you do a public task, then anybody on your account can see it.
Okay. And what do you want to put in the description?
Hey, make a video. How about that?
Good. Taskmaster Tony is at it again. Okay, so it's connected to the project now. Right. But since we're logged into my account, we'll go to a tasks and boom, there it is.
Yeah, this is the task list view, and you can quickly scan things to see when they're due. And since we're almost done with this video, let's go ahead and mark it complete.
Let's mark it complete. Video's done?
It's done. And you'll notice that next week's video already popped up there, so you'll get your reminder next week.
All right, so repeating tasks, they'll automatically pop up as soon as the preceding one is complete.
That is correct.
Cool. So before the end of the video, we wanted to mention there are a couple of ways to automate tasks. That is to trigger sets of tasks automatically depending on certain conditions being met. They are activity sets and pipelines along with
workflows. Yeah, workflow automation.
Workflow automation. So check out the videos at the end of this video if you'd like to learn more about automating your tasks.
It'll save you lots of data entry time.
A lot of time. And so anyway, go and create some tasks. Have fun.